on the brink of war with three different countries consecutively in a church. With one father's making reality shows about decadence and the other. Well, they were writing blogs about how the first part was wrong and the rest. Well, they didn't have running water or the governmental right to practice their faith, so they just died off. They say our nation's on its way to hell as if it's ever been in heaven in the first place. We are pieces of the perfect symphony, the Mozart of irony. Vincent Van Gogh that only paints with serendipity. Dipping his paint brushes in a messy patches of coincidences. And attacking a canvas like every splat I had a destiny. Broaden your horizons a little wider, you will see that perfect symmetry. Yo, it's all on purpose. I'm still all on purpose. My pappy takes the purpose. And British is a stamp of one of a kind and priceless. A cosmic thrift shop on back to war can only imagine. Why don't stuff we made himself from dust and earth, in other words, us. This is all my confidence.
This is what this nationally known, famous, mega church, coffee shop preacher said. His quote is, "Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so." Now, he's saying that in a mocking way. He said, "This is where our trouble began." He said, the implication is, the Bible is the reason we believe. I can believe Jesus loves me because it's in the Bible. The problem with that is this. If the Bible is the foundation of our faith, as the Bible goes, so goes our faith. If the Bible is the foundation of our faith, it is all or nothing.
Amen.
Amen. Yep. Christianity becomes a fragile house of cards religion. Christianity becomes a fragile house of cards that comes tumbling down when we discover that perhaps the walls of Jericho didn't. You know what he's telling you? He's telling you, oh, the archaeologists have been to Jericho and they determined that the walls didn't really fall down. Phooey on that!
Amen.
Scientists say that there is no whale on the earth that is capable of swallowing a whole man and holding it in his stomach. Fooey on that! Science has determined the earth is 3.5 million years old, and we used to be monkeys. Nonsense!
Amen.
Listen, this man hates the Bible.
Amen.
He said, everything rises and falls on whether not part, but all of the Bible is true. It is true, you idiot! What is wrong with you? And he said, that's unfortunate, and as we are going to discover today, unnecessary. The Christian faith does not exist because of the Bible. The Bible exists because of the Christian faith. Liar! Man's a liar!
Amen.
There's the quote. Those of you watching online, you can go dig it up. Guess who said this? Andy Stanley. He is the son of Charles Stanley. Look at this. Look at this one. He's got up here, we look to our religious traditions. Our problem is tradition, systemized, customized, or overemphasized and fossilized. The Bible said to follow the traditions given to us by the apostles. Paul told that to Timothy. Look at what he said here. He said, guys that preach verse by verse through books of the Bible, he said, that is just cheating. It's cheating because that would be easy. First of all, that isn't how you grow people. He's a liar. Deceiving people in church, telling them, oh, don't read your Bible. Reading your Bible is bad. You won't get anything from God reading your Bible, because the Bible may be wrong, and if the Bible's wrong, then your faith is wrong. You know what? He's right on that, but I'm going to tell you something, sir. The Bible is not wrong. Never has been, never will be.
Amen.
Amen. Give the Lord a hand. Makes me sick. Watch this now. Listen, that man is already been judged by God. Yeah. Ezekiel 14, turn there. I'm going to start reading while you're turning. The word, because I'm getting hungry. The word of the Lord came again to me, saying, son of man, when the land sinneth against me by trespassing grievously, then will I stretch out mine hand upon it, and I will break the staff of the bread thereof, and will send famine upon it, will cut off man and beast from it. Though these three men, Noah, Daniel, and Job, were in it, they should deliver but their own souls by their righteousness, saith the Lord God. This man may be thinking that because daddy was a preacher and daddy's accepted all of, then I'll be okay because I'm his son. God said, so what if I save his daddy? That's not going to protect you. And I'm just saying, I don't know anything about this man other than what I just showed you. But you know what I suspect based upon what I just read you out of the Bible? I suspect that he has grievous transgressions behind the scenes. That's what I think. Isaiah 32:6. For the vile person will speak villainy, and his heart will work iniquity, to practice hypocrisy and to utter error against the Lord, to make empty the soul of the hungry, and he will cause the drink of the thirsty to fail. That's what he did. People are coming to church because they need food for their soul. And the preacher causes them, he empties their soul and causes them to be hungry by telling them, oh, don't eat that Bible. That's not where it is. You know what he just said to everybody? Follow me. I'll give you the truth.
We got married. We came in with an extraordinary commitment to never, ever, ever carry credit card balance, always pay cash for cards. And the very first house we bought, we were told, you don't have to put that big of a down payment down. You know, you can actually finance and have a larger home if you don't. And both of us came in with this value system of no debt, no debt, no debt, no debt. So consequently, in 20 years of marriage, we never had a car payment. Always bought, previously owned cars on two occasions, and my parents helped us get a minivan because they wanted their grandkids safe.
Yo, fellas, y'all ready to do this?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, boys to men in full effect. Uh-huh. It's about that time.
Roll Town Billy back again. Doing a little East Coast swing. Voice of men going on. Not too hot, not too soft. Voice of men
probably gonna start a fight. I know this can't be right. Hey, baby, come on. I loved you endlessly when you weren't there for me. So now it's time to leave and make it alone. So
I know that I can't take no more. It ain't no lie. I wanna see you out that door. Bye-bye-bye. I don't wanna be a fool for you. Just another player in your game for two.
You may hate me, but it
ain't no lie. Bye-bye-bye. Don't really wanna make it tough. I just wanna tell you that I've had enough.
Ourselves a time machine, not just
the DeLorean.
The DeLorean is our time machine.
That is glorious.
Because this summer we're gonna have a lot of fun and go back to the future.
And the whole team thought this was a good idea.
Just trust me.
So you're telling me these buttons, this thing works?
Oh yeah, heck yeah, just like the movies.
Oh, just like Doc
just like the movies.
And here we go with a little 1970.
Whoa.
Wow.
The 70s.
Oh, I like this.
We look fabulous.
This is not how they wore that. They will put that around their head, not their neck. And your mustache is upside down.
I'm shaved tonight. I love the 70s.
I do too.
Yeah. I was born in 1973.
Oh, no way.
Yeah.
That's Nixon.
Yep. Richard Nixon.
Watergate. Oh, yeah.
I am not a criminal.
Quick question.
Yeah. Fire away.
Disco or soft rock?
Soft rock.
I'd say just Burt Reynolds.
That was really good.
Thank you.
You look like Burt Reynolds.
Well, I've been told worse. Listen, this is a little desperado right here in the time machine.
In the time machine.
All right, we're going to go back to the 70s here for a minute. Y'all hang with us. Tap along if you'd like.
Almost heaven.
West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like breeze. Country road, take me home to the grave.
On the farm is kind of laid back, and nothing old country boy like me can't hack. Early to rise, early in the sack, I thank God I'm a country boy. Well, a simple kind of life never did me no harm, raising me a family and working on the farm. The days are all filled with an easy country charm, I thank God I'm a country boy. Well, I got me a fine wife, I got me old fiddle, and the sun's coming up, I got cakes on the griddle. Life ain't nothing but a funny, funny riddle, thank God I'm a country boy. When the work's all done, the sun's up low, pull out my fiddle and a rosin on my boot. Kids are asleep, so keep it kind of low, I thank God I'm a country boy. Well, I play Sally Gooden all day if I could, but the Lord and my wife wouldn't take it very good. So I work when I can, work when I should, I thank God I'm a country boy. Well, I got me a fine life, I got me old fiddle, when the sun's coming up, the cake's on the griddle. Life ain't nothing but a funny, funny riddle, I thank God I'm a country boy. Come on, boy. I got me old fiddle when the sun's coming up, cakes on the griddle. Life ain't nothing but a funny, funny riddle. Woo! Thank God I'm a country boy. Here we go. We gon' do it, this it can't be done. We got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, is what's on bandit run. Keep your foot part on the pedal, so never mind them brakes. We've got to hang out, we've got to run me. My family's in Atlanta, we're here in Texarkana. We'll make it back no matter what it takes. Eastbound and down, loaded up and truck. We gon' do a this, it can't be done. We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch a bandit run. Play, boy! This it can't be done. We got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch your bandit run. I'm eastbound, watch your bandit run. I'm eastbound, just watch your bandit run. Yeah.
Welcome to North Point, everybody. How you feeling? Awesome. My name's Clay. If you're over here in the east, over in the west, watching us online, happy Father's Day to everybody. We're just hanging out here. It's Bring Your Child to Work Day. And Don't know if you caught that or not, but good news about that. This is the baby Bjorn right here. This is Cooper. Can you guys say hello to Cooper? Cooper, you can say hey back to them. A little wave, I don't know, pound, something. Hey, we are excited about Father's Day. A lot going on today here at North Point. We're not the only ones that got stuff going on. What's happening there? Over in the West, Evan's got some Father's Day stuff going on as well.
Hey, Clay.
Hey, Evan.
How you doing?
Evan, how's it hanging?
Heavy.
Heavy.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Evan, who we got with you?
This is my son, Miller, who's actually in middle school. Sorry, buddy.
I don't know who got the worst end of the deal, you or Miller. Miller, happy Father's Day to your dad. What'd you get your dad for Father's Day, Miller?
Wait, it's Father's Day? Oh, who cares?
See? Middle school.
Oh, that's great. Evan, how's it going over there?
Well, it's going, but we probably need to go pretty quickly. Oh, we are so excited that it's Father's Day. This is a big day, too. We got the U.S.
Big
Open
day.
Today.
Big day. Yes, big it day. Is.
Big, big day.
Yes, we got Game 7 NBA Finals tonight. Happy Father's Day to you dads, if that's your thing.
That's right. That's
or
right.
We got the finals of the U.S. Open, Evan. That's good news, too.
That's right. You go home and put on your quitters and just watch television all day long.
That's right. You got your pants on, which I love that.
Oh,
those red
gosh.
Pants. That's great.
I'm going to need some medicine. So here's the thing, in the honor of Father's Day, a
yes.
couple things going on. We've got a photo booth out there.
Yes, we do.
You should stop by and get your picture taken. We'll have the harness ready for you.
You can put your child right in it. That's right. Doesn't
That's
matter
right.
the age.
Doesn't matter the age. This thing is super comfortable. And then we also have a special gift for a couple of people here in the West and in the East.
Yes.
If you will just look under your chair, you'll find
a live cat. No. Look under your chair.
Help me. I lost my train of thought. There is a gift certificate to Topgolf.
Yes. Under
you can
two
take...
chairs over here in the East, over in the West.
That's
two
right.
Two of you are going to go play some Topgolf with the harness and your child.
That's right.
Anybody? We got any winner chicken dinner
Anybody?
Over here?
Nope. It's funny because we don't have many empty seats in here. It's just...
No winners. We got no winners. Anyone? Anybody want to go play top
no?
golf?
Well, maybe
no?
we're kidding. Maybe we don't have anything, Clay. So who wants to take Miller home with them?
Consolation prize.
Clay, I got to go. Tell
well,
them what else is happening.
Somebody's going to go home a winner today at some point, but we are genuinely glad you're here. Welcome to North Point. If you brought somebody today, we hope that you have a fantastic service, next hour and 5 minutes together with us. But honestly, on your way out today, maybe the best place to take your friend is by the studio. They can answer all your questions and hopefully have a conversation with you about how you can make this church your church, if that's something that you are interested in doing even after this shenanigan. So there we go, a wave. Hey, well, why don't we do this? Why don't you go ahead and stand up? We're going to sing a little bit. We're going to have some fun today, but we also want to bring some meaning to what's going on in the world. So say hello to somebody around you, and then we're going to sing all together.
Wonderful to be together and to get to have this time to sing these songs that are so filled with truth, especially after such a devastating and heartbreaking week for our country. So much loss with everything that's happened in Orlando. It reminds me that really the only true hope that we have is in Jesus. And even when we can't understand why things happen, we can place our trust in Jesus, who is a secure foundation, and the hope that we have in them really does go, in Him, it goes beyond the troubles that we have in this world. So that's what we're going to sing about. So here we go. We're going to sing Christ.
Loving versus leading, truth versus grace, me versus we, popularity versus purpose, the already and the not yet. The tension causes us to stretch in new directions. Through the tension, we change, and through the change, we grow. And it happens in the very place that causes many leaders to flinch, fear, and fail. But the tension we resist is actually by design. It tries us, it tests us, but it conforms us to His image. The tension is necessary. The tension makes us strong. The tension is good. The tension is good.
Thank you. could that be good when all I want is tranquility? Peace to feel solace, but I feel a pull on my brave heart like Will Wallace. I call into a battle that's fought in the mundane. Engaged behind my own closed doors with no shame. No Hollywood movie that's spliced in ice cream, but a story of warriors who fight with ice veins. Go against the grain, knowingly face pain. Unafraid nor shy, just to die is great fame. Don't trust in chariots, horses of freight train. Name of a father whose love can break chains. And some may call us insane, but to press through the rubbish, to reach beyond rage, to give beyond means. Love without rage, tension is good, it's a catalyst for change. Hey, come on.
if you're black or white. I wanna go with you all night.
now is the time to come together. It's time to shine and blow the roof. Fuck this joint, one heart and one mind. We got buckets and wood blocks and tambourines, making noise, having fun. It's such a crazy scene. It's a ball when we all make noise from wall to wall. Let's come together, y'all. Let's come together, y'all. Hey!
Thank you.
used to look into my father's eyes. In a happy home, there was a king on a gold throne. But those days are gone, and now the memory is on the wall. And I hear the songs from the places where I was born. Oh. My father said, don't you worry, child. See, heaven's got a plan for you. Don't you worry now. Hey.
The heart is a bloom. Springs up from the stony ground. If there's no room, no space to rent in this town, you thought you found a friend to take you out of this place. Someone you could lend a hand in return for grace. It's a beautiful day. The sky falls, it feels like a beautiful day. Don't let it get away. It's a beautiful day.
Displaced in the midst of the fear, I can still hear a voice saying, don't you worry, child. Hope is rising up from the grave. A brand new day is here right now.
Christmas, everyone.
Ho, ho, ho. My name is Joseph.
And I'm Clay. Look, we were just talking about how much we love Christmas, but sometimes the music can get just a little tired.
It can. It's a little weird.
It actually is. The little drummer boy, for instance, have you ever thought about what bad parenting it is to let your child play drums around an infant?
That's preposterous.
Completely.
And the oxen lamb that kept time.
That's just ridiculous. I think everyone knows that oxen are notoriously bad with their rhythm.
You know what we need to do?
What?
We need to write our own Christmas song.
I love it.
I mean, we have enough talent at all our churches to do this, right?
Of course we do.
Here's what we'll do. We'll take this to the Christmas experts and let them start writing some lyrics.
Perfect. Let's go.
What's your most favorite part about Christmas?
I like the parties. I like the Christmas parties.
Because of Jesus and because of presents and because my elf comes.
Do you write Santa a note?
Yes.
Uh-huh. What do you write him?
I write him that I like toys and I like...
What's the worst Christmas present you've ever got?
Blue underwear.
I think Santa's underwear smells like cheese.
It does.
I like cheese. And I like homework.
Legacy.
Homework?
Yes.
Is that what she said?
You can't learn nothing and you don't know about nothing.
What do y'all know about the Christmas story?
Jesus was born on Christmas. And an angel came down. I can't remember the rest.
That's a big part.
So when Mary realized that she was pregnant, how did she realize she was pregnant? How did she find out?
The doctor said.
So Mary and Joseph, they travel a long way. Do you remember where they were going?
Bevelton, or what?
Bevelton.
Bevelton.
Bevelton, Pennsylvania. Yes. It's a beautiful town.
Yes.
Bethlehem.
Lefleham.
It's Bethlehem, and I'm left-handed. And then they went to this inn, and they tried to find a place to stay. Do you remember that part? And what happened then?
They had to live in a barn.
Mm-hmm. They had to live in a barn. There's Why did they have to live in a barn?
Ew, that's really stinky.
It is, I know. Or, tell us what you would say.
I don't want to smell animals' business.
Do you think that they, you think they were trying to get to the Holiday Inn? Or you think there was a
Hampton Inn?
All the houses, or all the hotels and motels and houses were full.
So what did the wise men bring to Jesus?
Like silver, gold.
Lots of merchandise. I know that.
Lots of merchandise. If you went to visit Jesus, what would you bring him?
What did they bring him?
Crown. You know what? I think a duck will be nice.
A crown, a duck, and what else?
A pencil. I thought there was two guys there.
Two guys?
That had canes.
They had canes?
Yeah.
Like because they were like walking on canes?
There was a shepherd man. Angel came down to the shepherd man and said,
yes.
There's a new...
And then a lot of your savior has been born.
Mm-hmm. How old do you think Santa is?
Old. I think the cookies keep him alive.
What rhymes with manger?
Ranger.
Danger.
Stranger.
Stranger.
However, Manger.
Tell me this. Jesus was born in a barn. What kind of animals do you think were in that barn?
Scorpions.
They're always there. Yeah.
Snake. Yeah.
A platypus is one of the ones that lays eggs.
Yeah.
I'm thinking there might have been a couple of bees.
Liger?
No.
No ligers.
That'd be cool if there was one.
I don't think they were even made back then.
What does an ox say?
Moo.
Ding 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 ding.
We have some solid gold right here.
Silver at best, I would say.
Oh, come on, listen, when we take this to our music gurus and let them work their magic?
It needs to be a Christmas miracle.
Well, then that's what we're gonna get, because we are gonna have the best Christmas carol ever.
All right, I'm with you, let's do it.
Hey everybody, thanks for coming. We're gonna be learning a brand new song today.
Do I look like an idiot? Okay.
Santa Claus.
Who wrote this? They're making us sing what?
Smell an animal's business?
What? That was horrible.
I have a deja vu.
This is so weird. Take one. Can't learn nothing, don't know nothing.
Old and the cookies keep him alive. I tell Santa Claus what I like and I like and I like.
Silver and gold and merchandise. Blue underwear that fits too tight. Can you smell it?
I think I can smell it.
Is bigger than Santa Claus. Wrapped in jeans, he was born in a barn.
Can you smell it?
I think I can smell it.
In Bethlehem. Oh wait, was it Bethlehem?
It's Christmas,
hey.
In a town called Bethlehem.
It's Christmas,
hey.
They didn't have no Hampton Inn.
They're smelling animals' business.
Ew.
Kitty kings and shepherds.
There's a stranger in a manger. How a ranger.
It's Christmas in Bethel Town.
Reindeers and mammals, platypus lay the eggs. Goblins in the barn, tiny little legs.
I think there were ligers.
Were there ligers back then?
Yeah, there were ligers back then.
Yeah, there were ligers back then.
Two buzzing bees, a snake, and a pig.
All the animals.
What does the ox say?
Moo, 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 wee haw.
Jesus and the presence and my help.
Hey, Mary, ain't no more room.
I just want to leave Joseph, we're having a baby.
Ah, Mary, I know you're pregnant, but you're driving me crazy.
All the hotels and the motels and the houses have been full.
The wise men brought crowns, ducks, and pencils.
He was wrapped in wrapped the paper that wasn't invented yet.
He was wrapped in jeans in a haystack and a blanket.
He was born in a manger, y'all. In a manger, y'all. In a manger, y'all.
Born in a manger, y'all.
Last year all I got was blue underwear.
Still smell the cheese in Santa's feet.
All around the world.
Let our noses burn.
It's Christmas in a town called Bevelton. It's Christmas. They have no Hampton Inn. Smelling animals business. Candy canes and shepherd men. There's a stranger in a manger.
Christmas in Bevelton. Oh, in Bevelton. It's Christmas in Bevelton.
Felt the healing. like fire, burning desire. I have spoke with the tongue of angels. I have held the hand of the devil. It was warm in the night. It was cold as a stone. But I still haven't found what I'm looking for.
Thank you.
is an incredible way to welcome you to North Point.
Thank you.
Buckhead this morning? There we go. Welcome to church. My name is Snow. Thanks for coming. We're about to start a new series here at Buckhead Church called Illusions. Today is the first Sunday of that series. So if you would please stand and greet one another around and people that you don't know. Thank you very much. Have a good day.
Good morning, everybody. Hope you're doing well today. My name's Clay. I'm one of the pastors here at North Point. Whether you're watching us online, whether you're over in the West or even over here in the East, we're so glad that you're here today. Are you guys feeling well this morning? By way of applause, I would say just okay. That's good. All right. Well, we hope it will only get better from here. We love to have fun around here. So if you're brand new to North Point, we hope you feel like it's okay to smile in a church, because we hope to make you smile a little bit this morning. We've been having fun with the idea of March, all things March. March Madness is exciting, but even more exciting than March Madness is a little mad Marchness, which we've been doing the last couple weeks. And this morning is no different. We're going to play a game that I like to call In the Bag. There we go. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for this young man. Your name?
My name is Matt.
Matt. Matt, you look fantastic. I love the getup. You're excited to be here, I suppose.
Sure.
Sure you are, because you have to be here. That's great. All right, well, Matt, we're going to play a little game called In the Bag. I've got a gift card to Top Golf burning a hole in my pocket. I would love to give it to you, and will give it to you if you can name these tunes. In the Bag, very straightforward game. We're going to play a couple of tunes. You just name the tune, and if you can name them correctly, then you will win the gift card. Crowd, I hope you're ready to play. You know what, Matt? Something about you seems off. I don't know if it's the hat or the beard or what it is.
There's probably a lot that's off.
That's right. But since it is St. Patrick's Day right around the corner, people, I think it might be better if we played the game this way. Would you guys please welcome to the stage our resident bagpiper, Mr. Robbie Rogers. Come on out, Robbie. Wonderful. I love that. All right. Matt, now I know a lot of you are probably thinking, bagpipes, isn't that a Scottish thing? Well, yes and no. All right. Yes and no. It is primarily Scottish, but the bagpipes were also from Ireland as well. And so if you are of Irish descent, I hope you're not offended by this. I think anyone from Ireland would be okay with bagpipes. It's still traditional Irish music. You guys get the point. We're going to have a lot of fun with it. Here's the way we're going to play, Matt. In honor of St. Patrick's Day. What's that?
I'm highly offended, by the way.
You're highly offended. That's okay. Well, you look the part, and that's all that matters. Here's the way this is going to work. Robbie is going to play some very familiar music to you on the bagpipe, okay? They're current modern-day songs. Play it on the bagpipe. You've got to guess the name of them. If you can, then you will win this gift card. Robbie, on your cue, play us the first song.
Star Wars.
Star Wars is correct. Well done, Matt. You are 1-for-1. That's terrific. Let's play the second song, Robbie. Anyone from the audience or online want to help us out here? The Final Countdown by the band Europe. It was their one hit, but a hit it was. And Matt, you are 1-for-2, which means you must get this last song. But I will tell you, we're going to make it a little bit easier for you, all right? This last one has been one of the most popular songs for the last couple years, and I think not only you will recognize it, but it might just make you want to do your own little jig. Robbie, go ahead. Yet so far away, Matt. It is not single ladies. That was actually single Lotties. I am so sorry, Matt. You were so close. You were so close. I'm not going to let you leave empty-handed. There's a gift card for you, Matt. Get out of here. Thanks for playing along. Can you guys make a little noise for Robbie? Such a great man. Such a great bagpiper. That's how we play in the bag. Over to you, Adam in the West.
See what it looked like in slow motion. Here he comes. Yeah, give him another hand. Ladies and gentlemen, Professor Splash, one more time. Yeah, 35 feet, 9 inches. Give him one more hand, a Catalyst New World Record.
Yeah. Yeah. that wickedness.
And here we have some more Justin Timberlake for you. Joey for you, huh?
I actually heard the song all the way through for the first time this week because I was 4 when it came out, which is a little embarrassing.
Yeah.
all you do is play. Cause I'm a cowboy. Yeah. On a steel horse I ride. I'm a warrior.
Loving this, aren't you, people?
What do you mean, stretch? Oh, we're not ready? Are we gone? Hello again, it's me, Susanna, backstage. We are just gonna get started in a few seconds, so. What do you mean, Rob? There are people out there. But we're really glad you're here. What else do you want me to say? I don't have anything else to say. You know what, just call them. Call them now. We have to get started. We don't have any more time. I'm gonna go take care of a few things. Super glad you're here. Where are they?
So that's why I've called in this emergency Christmas creative meeting and invited some all-stars to know big, because we need big. So just start throwing out some ideas, and remember, there's no such thing as a bad idea.
Well, I've been taking this interpretive dance class, and...
Okay, that's a bad idea. Anyone else?
John, I've got an idea.
My man, Jeff Foxworthy, you might be a redneck professional entertainer. Give it to me. What do you got?
All right, you know, I've been in the business a long time. Got a lot of connections.
Yep. I like where this is heading.
All right. Yeah. My Uncle Junior has got a sleigh, and my other Uncle Junior has a reindeer. Okay?
Jeff, I love it. Make it happen.
All right, just to be clear, now by sleigh, I mean a 64 El Camino, and by reindeer, my other Uncle Junior has these antlers that kind of go like...
Jeff, no, that's terrible.
Okay. Is it terrible, or is it spectacaganza?
It's terrible.
That's what I thought! What if we had somebody...
somebody kick a football into the audience, you know, like they do in a football game.
Drum, that's not even just a terrible idea. It's not even safe. What if it hits an old person in the face?
That would be just terrible.
Come on, does anybody have a good creative idea? What about you?
Well, I've been a little busy.
We're all busy, Santa. I mean, I just finished 80 straight nights of touring all around the globe, and you work one night.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, that is so Brian from the Backstreet Boys.
This Brian from the Backstreet Boys.
Yeah, that is your mother's Justin Bieber.
And if it's their first time with us, they can pick up a free CD with a special message from our campus pastors.
Who are you talking to?
Our first timers.
Okay, what about a song?
What about just a song?
Yeah, a song.
Just a song? Bad idea. Besides, nobody wants it that way.
But I want it that way. And of course, Backstreet's back.
All right.
Hi, I'm Bob Bess, her husband.
I want football.
I got a football. My Aunt Faylene made it for me for Christmas when I was six. It's made out of a possum.
All right, Chuck, that's disgusting and probably illegal. Can we just stop the madness? We've got a service beginning in a few minutes, and all we've talked about so far is a stupid football.
And dancing.
Yeah.
Is he always this mean?
Yes.
Can somebody please just give me some good news?
This just in, the Christmas service starts in 2 minutes.
Brenda, seriously, do you think that's helpful?
Coming up at 11, John gets coal in his stocking yet again.
This is ridiculous. Guys, I need an idea that is so big that an audience could feel it right now.
Well, we definitely have to have carolers.
Feeling the carolers.
How about a little snow? How about a lot of snow?
And some ice.
I think we should rent a bunch of reindeer.
Yay!
No livestock.
Aww.
Brian, did you change clothes again?
I'm telling you, we need carolers.
No carolers.
Well, I think we ought to have some elves.
And they need to be throwing snowballs.
Yeah, and shepherds giving out free cups of hot chocolate.
Angels on high,
dropping manna from heaven.
What's manna?
I think it's like donuts.
Dropping Krispy Kreme donuts from heaven.
This is Christmas. It's the most important day of the year. So we can't do an opener with elves and reindeers and donuts and a football. This is a celebration where a choir of angels sang. Where the sky was lit by a bright star that led strangers to a child, a baby in a manger, and this baby would change the world forever. That's what this celebration is about. Okay, so come on, just each one of you, just give me one
The devil went down to Georgia.
Santa went down to Georgia. He was flying on a big old sleigh with a sack of toys for girls and boys to give on Christmas Day. But he slithered down a chimney like he'd always done before. But this one house was set apart with a treat he couldn't ignore. See, other kids gave cookies, but this young boy, he was sly. Hit a 15 dozen Krispy Kremes, fresh hot, piled up high. He licked those ruby lips of his and downed a dozen at a time. But in his haste, he found his waist a double now inside. He washed them down with a glass of milk inside with great delight, and waddled to the fireplace as he pushed with all his might. Sweat poured down his rosy cheeks till he didn't fit. With this big old belly all full of jelly, he ain't never gonna fit. That little boy had laid a trap for old Saint Nick, you see. But Santa was a wise old man and had something up his sleeve. Oh, I bet you didn't know this, but I've sung a song or two. And if you care to take a dare, I'll make a bet with you. I'll tell you a Christmas song, as pretty as you know. You've got me pinned, but if I win, you've gotta let me forego. The boy said, my name's Johnny, and though I'm only four, I'll take your bet you're gonna regret, cause you're never getting out that door. As it cast its crimson glow, he pushed those fangs across his brow and he struck the rock star pose. Then he brought that windmill alarm around and a mighty sound arose. Johnny Bob's head because he knew that he would beat. He laid the key to his front door on the ground at Santa's feet. Santa said, "Boy, I'm here to cheer if you ever want to try again. Cause I'm jolly old St. Nicholas, the best that's ever been." Ho, 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 ho.
Jingles with bells of holly.
Differences and all, young and old, every single color, every language on earth, rich and poor, lifting up one name that is above every name, the name of our Savior Jesus Christ, the King of Kings.
Yeah, but your Jesus is the false one. Action.
What is God speaking into your soul? What dreams and visions are waiting to be born? Because you are God's species, God's instrument to create a future that only He could imagine. The question is not whether you will create. The question is, what kind of world will we create?
Is that Mary Poppins? Nice
skinny jeans. Stir one or another to disturb the people that need to be disturbed. Be the leader that starts with wow and only asks how when you absolutely have to.
Oh, wonderful. Goodness. Oh, magic! Yes, wonderful!
Stop being satisfied with knowing what you should do. Step out and trust God and obey Him. Step out and trust
Yes,
God.
Obey God. That means quit yoking up with the world.
Let the blessing come.
And quit pouring magic. Lord, rebuke these wicked devils. Andy Stanley, you wicked devil. You're going to be fully exposed, you wicked devil. I just wanted to add this into the video. I'm doing some Catalyst Conference highlights aside from all the other worldliness at the Andy Stanley shows. And here we have an advertisement for Tony Robbins. Professional coaching certification, a life-changing experience. He's a motivational speaker, life coach, new ager, extraordinaire. And it's funny how he's being advertised on Andy Stanley Catalyst Conference videos. I just thought I would add this in. If you're not familiar with Tony Robbins, just look into some of his work. He's a total new ager, you know, affiliated with Oprah and the such. So it's no big thing, you know, that he's being advertised on the Catalyst Conference highlights. So just thought I would include that in. God bless you guys. Enjoy the next show.
I found life and I found laughter in forgiveness. I found rest on the shoulders of redemption. I found hope when hope was dead. I could lose it in a moment. So I dare not close my eyes. I'll watch fear fall with the sunset.
Christian, but comfort and safety were paralyzing me.
The fear of failure drives you to lead without faith.
Nike 666 girl show.
Without faith, it is impossible to please God.
Here's something beautiful about our God. He puts to use what he puts you.
Totally feminine.
The only way the world will see Jesus is if we live the impossible life.
You have no idea what happened.
hangs in the balance of your decision to embrace the burden that God has placed on your heart.
I think that we'll spend our whole life trying to grasp about how big he really is, but I just take one day at a time, and I don't look at it as, wow, all these great things are happening, or all these things are changing, but I just think about, okay, God, what do you want me to do today?
Notice everybody how trendy everyone is with their skinny jeans and their dressy t-shirts and their wispy little beards. Awaken the wonder. Yes, let's awaken the wonder. Lord, rebuke these wicked devils, man. I just pray for that people come out of this deception in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. All right, here we got some more Tony Robbins being promoted. And here he is throwing the 666 up. Wonderful. He claims to be a Christian, though he cusses like a sailor. So if you ever get time, look into Tony Robbins a little bit and see why he may have something to do with all this as well. Part of the law of attraction. He's a promoter and pusher of what's called the law of attraction. It's New Age. You know, thinking it into existence and speaking it into existence, so on and so forth. So here we're going to take a look at some more Catalyst Conference highlights. Some more Mary Poppins. I apologize ahead of time for Christine Kane's annoying voice.
You know what I'm really afraid of?
But it is what it is.
When I get to heaven, God will flash up on the screen all the things that I did for him. And then he'll flash up on another screen all the things that I could have done with the gifts and the talents and the dreams he put in me. And what I did will give in comparison to what I could have done. There is a gift on the inside of you. There is a gift on the inside of you. And we are waiting to see you awaken to the wonder of what God has put on the inside of you. You have got to stir up what God has put on the inside of you.
Shut down wonder in people around you.
This is Trip Lee talking about engaging the culture, because that's what it's all about. Even though scripture says in James 4 and chapter 4 and verse 4, it says, and I'm going to read it verbatim, word for word, "Ye adulterers and adulteresses, know ye not that the friendship of the world is enmity with God? Whosoever therefore will be a friend of the world is the enemy of God." That's James 4:4. Now let's see what Triple E has to say. Not that it really matters, but just to prove a point.
We know that God has called us to be present in this world. And I assume everyone here understands that for us, the proper response for the Christian is not, ooh, culture is gross, let me get away from it. But instead to think about how we can engage it in a way that honors God. God doesn't say this world is dark, so go over and make light somewhere in the corner. Instead, he says, you're the light of the world. And then, he doesn't just say, so I find this interesting, the scripture doesn't just call us to trust in Jesus, who John calls the true light, and just to walk in the light, like John says in 1 John 1, but it also calls us ourselves to be the light of the world, but not just the light of the world somewhere in private. It actually says, let your light shine before men. Scripture wants us to be a light and to purposely let other people see it, like on purpose.
By acting like the world.
Let your light shine before men.
By acting like the world.
City set on the hill can't be hidden.
By acting like the world.
Even in a dark culture, God wants us to engage as light bearers.
According to them, by acting like the world, though. That's how they engage the world. And engage the culture.
So I fell in love with hip-hop before I actually even fell in love with Jesus.
You fell in love with hip-hop.
So when I fall in love with Jesus, and I'm already in love with this art form that's known for things that are contrary to what Jesus teaches, I then have to think, how am I supposed to move forward? Now, there were a lot of people who would tell me to just throw out hip-hop altogether, say the culture itself is inherently sinful.
It is.
But I think when we start to throw out entire cultures and people groups and expressions as inherently sinful and unredeemable, I think we say something about the gospel that we don't mean to be saying. I think what we accidentally say about the gospel is that the gospel is the power of God for salvation to these peoples and these cultures, but not these.
So should prostitutes and strippers keep being prostitutes and strippers, Triply?
I didn't understand theology very well. I was still learning my Bible, but I knew that couldn't be true. And so I began to think about it. How can I do hip-hop in a way to honor God? I don't think it's inherently sinful itself. And I loved hip-hop. It was a beautiful art form. I mean, the way hip-hop uses, I mean, there's a lot of it that's a lot more complex than I give. The way hip-hop uses metaphors is unlike any other art form. The way hip-hop uses symbols, the way hip-hop does storytelling, the way hip-hop connects with your soul is very unique. And I thought, I want to be a part of this beautiful art form. So what happens with culture is that God has given us creation in these raw materials like the human mind and sound and thoughts. And what we get to do is we get to kind of use those raw materials and craft them into something else. That's the beautiful thing that hip-hop is. And I wanted to take part in that, and I wanted to do that in a way that honors God.
Instead of forsaking your idols.
That was me thinking through, how can I actually engage culture even though it's been used improperly?
And again, we see anybody can be a teacher nowadays. Lecrae talks the same thing about engaging the culture. But since that wasn't...
Well, I fell in love.
Since that wasn't from Andy Stanley... or the Catalyst Conference, I'm not actually going to play Lecrae speaking about it. I'm just covering literally anything that's affiliated with Andy Stanley at the moment, because that's what this little video documentary is all about, is exposing the unfruitful works of Andy Stanley and North Point Ministries and Gwinnett Church and the Catalyst Conference and Buckhead Church and Browns Bridge Church and Woodstock City Church and any other Decatur City Church and any other church ministry affiliated with Andy Stanley. See, Andy Stanley, you're leading a lot of people to hell with a false gospel. And as watchmen on the wall, as born-again, Bible-believing Christians, it's our job to expose these unfruitful works of darkness. We are to reprove them. We are to rebuke. We are to exhort with all long-suffering, because a time will come where they will not endure sound doctrine, but they'll heap to themselves teachers having itching ears. And they'll turn away from sound doctrine, and they'll turn onto fables. And that's what's happening, is people are churning themselves onto fables. They want to hear that secular music. They're getting drawn in by the secular music, and they're staying there for the secular music. They're not staying there for Jesus. They're getting drawn in by secular music. Well, the Word of God says faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. Not by the hearing of Van Halen, not by the hearing of Whitesnake, not by the hearing of Michael Jackson or Eminem or the Beatles, but by hearing by the Word of God. The Word of God. The Word of God. And you, Andy Stanley, you cast doubt on the Word of God. You cast doubt on the Word of God, Andy Stanley. But see, it's our job to reprove you and to rebuke you, you wicked devil. And I pray, if it's possible, I pray you repent and you actually get saved. If it's possible, if you're not already reprobate. And that's what I'm doing today, by exposing all your unfruitful works of darkness. Just looking at different videos that were uploaded by your ministries. And there's so much. I could probably keep going and finding more and more and more and more, but I think we get the point, as much as I've already uploaded and will upload. I mean, here we have a lip sync battle. I mean, it's just ridiculous. And if anybody wants to take a look at some of the stuff for themselves, they can just go to Catalyst Leader, the Catalyst Leader YouTube channel. You can go to the North Point Ministries YouTube channel, and so on and so forth. I mean, there's so much. Here we got Tony Romo and Matt Chandler, Francis Chan. We got Priscilla Shire. She's from The War Room. I mean, just so much. Back in 2009, they had Rick Warren. Judah Smith, Lecrae, one of the Duck Dynasty guys, Mark Batterson. He's the author of The Circle Maker. Yeah, let's use witchcraft. That sounds wonderful. I mean, it just goes on and on and on with this ministry. There's no limits. There's no limits with this ministry. There's none whatsoever. So I think I've included more than enough, and I'll let you guys just look and research on your own. But I think with all the video footage I've included thus far, I think that's more than plenty to prove the point that Andy Stanley's ministry, his ministries, his books, his conferences, and anybody affiliated with him, whether it's Louis Giglio, Rick Warren, Craig Gauchel, Elevation Church, Hillsong Church, Francis Chan, Christine Kane, Beth Moore, any of these people, Mark Batterson, anybody from Together 2016, and any of these other conferences, the C3 Conference, the Code Orange Revival, the Awakening Conferences, Harvest, any of these conferences, any of let's just call them what they are, any of these performers, any of these motivational speakers, they all should be marked and avoided, as it says in Romans 16, verses 17 and 18. You know, Paul, he gave us plenty of exhortations on what would be taking place back then and even now. And it says, "Now I beseech you, brethren, mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which ye have learned, and avoid them. For they that are such serve not our Lord Jesus Christ, but their own belly, and by good works and fair speeches deceive the hearts of the simple." They cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine. Now see, people like this, they would take that scripture and they would say that I'm causing division. But it's not contrary to the doctrine that was received at antiquity. They're causing divisions according to the doctrine that was received at antiquity. From the very inception of born-again Bible believers that took place during the days that our Lord and Savior walked on this earth. So I pray right now in the mighty name of Jesus that whoever sees this video from North Point Ministries and anybody affiliated with that ministry, and if you know anybody who goes to that church or is affiliated with that ministry, I pray you share this with them. And I pray their eyes be opened. Because the Word of God says, and we repeat the scripture over and over again when we go out and preach, whether it's at this event, whether it's at the Michael W. Smith concert or any of these different conferences in general, or at the Andy Stanley Church when we were there this past weekend. It says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes and the pride of life, is not of the Father, but it is of the world. And the world passeth away in the lust thereof, but he that doeth the will of God abideth forever. He that doeth the will of God will abide forever. And it also says in John 15, if the world hate you, ye know that it hated me before it hated you. If ye were of the world would love his own. But because ye are not of the world, but I have chosen you out of the world, therefore the world hateth you. Remember the word that I said unto you, the servant is not greater than his Lord. If they have persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they have kept my saying, they will keep yours also. But all these things will they do unto you for my name's sake, because they know not him that sent me. If I had not come and spoken unto them, they had not had sin. But now they have no cloak for their sin. He that hateth me hateth my Father also. See, the world loves this kind of church. The world loves it. It's entertaining. It's very, very entertaining. And what does the Word of God say about entertainment? Here's what the Word of God says about what we are to set our affections on, what we're to set our mind on, what we're to meditate upon. Psalm 39:3. My heart was hot within me. While I was musing, the fire burned. Then spake I with my tongue, Lord, make me to know mine end, and the measure of my days, what it is, that I may know how frail I am. Now, I'm not going to read all that. My main point for sharing this scripture is the word musings. The word musings means to like think upon, to meditate upon. So essentially, that's what the word muse means. Well, just like the word theist means to believe and know God. Atheist means, you know, you don't believe in God, you don't know God. So the word muse means to meditate upon, to think upon. The word amuse means to be entertained, to be diverted, to be distracted. And that's what we see with these types of churches. It's all about the amusements. It's all about the entertainments. They're not being mused by the Word of God. They're being amused by the worldly distractions, by the worldly entertainments, by the secular music. You know, they have Six Flags over Atlanta. It's Dale Bronner's church that we will eventually be preaching outside of that. It's at the epicenter. It's by Six Flags, which is the Six Flags Atlanta, even though it's not technically in Atlanta. And that's what it's all about. It's all about amusement parks. It's all about theme parks. And that's what these kind of churches are about. It's all about their different themes and all about their different amusements to amuse and to entertain and to divert and to distract people from and away from the Word of God, not to the Word of God. Once again, faith cometh by hearing and hearing by the Word of God. It doesn't come by all this worldly and secular entertainment, magicians and cannonball and circus shows and the rock concerts and the low lights and the glow sticks and the dubstep and the rap concerts and the lip syncing and the drums and the beatboxing. What does any of this have to do with Jesus Christ? You want to engage the culture, Trip Lee and Lecrae? Preach the gospel. Be instant in season, out of season. Reprove, rebuke with all long suffering. That is what we're to do. That is what we're to do. I always use this quote, but I want to quote it word for word. It comes from Charles Haddon Spurgeon. And he talked of a time. He talked of a time of instead of feeding the sheep, there would be the amusement of goats. The amusement of goats. The amusement of goats. Amusing the goats. So the goats are musing on the amusements. They want to be entertained. They want to hear the comedy routines and the comedy skits and the jokes, etc. I'm trying to find the exact quote here. Please bear with me. This is all just coming to me while I'm just putting this together. Okay, and Spurgeon said, I'm going to zoom in on this. He said, a time will come when instead of shepherds feeding the sheep, the church will have clowns entertaining the goats. So yes, Andy Stanley, you're a clown. You know, and it's funny, Spurgeon said this. This was probably, I'm guessing, about 140, 150 years ago or so. I actually have this right here. This little image. I have this actually on my Instagram page. But we see it's so true. This is so true. So what are we gonna do about it? What are we going to do about this? Are we going to sit in our seats, sit in our chairs, sit in our pews on Sunday and not do anything about it? Or are we going to be men of God and are we going to go into the world and preach the gospel? No matter what anybody says, no matter what anybody thinks, no matter how they look at us. The Word of God says that we're going to be hated by the world. We're not going to be loved by the world. So this is my call to all the men of God out there. This is my call. If you have churches like this in your city or in your town, to go out and stand for the truth and preach the gospel, preach it in truth, no matter what the consequences may be, no matter how people may look at you. We are to go into the world. We're not to bring the world into the church and entertain the world and amuse them with little comedy routines. That's not what God had set up. So God bless you all. I love you. I pray this video blesses and touches each and every one of you. And I plead the blood of Jesus over anybody who sees this and anybody who shares this. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.